students, myself Lokesh, working as assistant professor in Vidyan Lara Institute of Technology and Science. So in our previous class, we have started railway fastenings. What are these? Railway fastening. These are nothing but fixtures which are used to connect various components of railway track, right? So the first railway fastening is fish plate. So what is this fish plate? Fish plate is used to connect two longitudinal rails at the rail joints. Okay. The second one is bolts. There are four types of bolts available. The first one is fish bolt, and the second one is hook bolt. Third one is fang bolt. And the last one is rag bolt. These are the four types of bolts available. Okay, coming to the first one, fish bolt. Fish bolt is generally used to connect fish plates to the rails. The second one is hook bolt. Hook bolt is used to connect timber sleepers to the bridge girder rails. Okay, there is a type of joint called bridge girder joint. So in that joint, we use hook bolts to connect bridge girder to the timber sleepers. Coming to the next one, fang bolts. Fang bolts are used to connect chains to the sleepers. Okay, chains are nothing but the arrangement to keep double headed rails and bull headed rails in position. Okay, coming to the last one, rag bolts. Rag bolts are used to connect sleepers to the rails. Okay, these are the four types of bolts available. Based on the purpose, they are divided into four types. And similarly, fish bolts also. Fish bolts are classified into two types. The first one is bone-shaped fish bolt. And the second one is increased depth fish bolt. Sorry, fish plate. These are the two types of fish bolts, fish plates available. Okay. These two topics we already completed in our last class. So coming to the next fastening, that is spikes. Okay, and the next one is chains. Fifth one, keys. Sixth one, bearing plate. And the last one is blocks. Okay, these are the seven types of fastening that we use to connect various components of a permanent wheel. Okay, so let's start with the spikes, because these two are already completed in our last class. So coming to the spikes. So what is the spike? Spike is nothing but a nail which is used to connect sleeper rails to the wooden sleepers. Okay, these are mainly used to hold rails to the wooden sleepers. Spikes are generally used for wooden sleepers, but some type of spikes can also be used for other type of sleepers also, that is steel sleepers and concrete sleepers. But main intention of using spikes is to connect rails to the wooden sleepers. Okay, so a rail spike is a large nail. Spike is nothing but a nail, but the difference is it has a offset head. Okay, but the nails doesn't have any offset head, but the spikes are similar to nail with an offset head that are used to secure rails, okay, and base plates of the sleepers, if any base plates we use. Okay, base plate is nothing but a bearing plate. Those are also generally used in the case of wooden sleepers only. For any other type of sleepers, we do not use this base plate. Okay, only for the wooden sleepers, we use this base plate. If we use any base plate, then these spikes are also used to secure rails and base plates to the sleepers. Okay, so let's come to the first one, dog spikes. Okay, dog spike means this is a dog spike. See, it is nothing but a nail, but it has a offset head. See, this is a line view. Okay, so let's come one by one. These are the most commonly used type of spikes. And the second one is hold rail flanges with the timber sleeper. Flange. Flange means nothing but a flat footed rail. Okay, so what is a rail? Rails are flat footed rails, are generally in this shape. Okay, this is known as head of the rail. and this is known as web of the rail, and this is known as flange or foot of the rail. Okay, these are the various names for rails. So what we are using, we are used to hold the flanges with the sleepers. Okay, so the next one, the shape of the head of spike resembles ear of a dog. So the head of the rail spike is seems to be like a ear of the dog, so that's why it is known as a dog spike. Okay, the next one is, this is the very cheapest and easy in fixing and also removing from sleepers. Okay, these are available in very low cost and we can also easily assemble and disable from the sleepers. But the main drawback of this dog spikes is these are getting loosened during the vibrations or during the impact loads. For a railway engineering, the impact and vibration loads are the very common loads. Okay, while the train moving over the rails, obviously the vibrations and impacts may generate. But because of those vibration impacts, these dog spikes may get loosened because there is no threading system. Okay, we are just inserting with some impact. Coming to the next one, section of spike is generally square and the bottom is weathered. See here, whether it is a pointed bottom or chisel bottom. Okay, the bottom is seems to be like a chisel, or it has to be like a point bottom, and the head is obviously a square one. Okay, so this is the shape, and these are the better to use to maintain the gauges. Okay, so this is a dog spike. See, this is our flat footed rail. Below the flat footed rail, this is a bearing plate. As we already discussed, bearing plates are used only for wooden sleepers. Okay, here the spikes are also used for wooden sleepers only. See, it is a flange of the rail, it is a bearing plate, and this one is a sleeper. See these dotted lines. These dotted lines are the dog spikes. See how they are inserted to hold the flange of the rail with the sleeper and base plate. See, this is an individual line diagram. Okay, so this is how we fix the rail to the sleepers using dog spikes. See the practical image. See, this is a wooden sleeper. This is a fish plate. Below the fish plate, there is a flange of the web, flange of the rail. Okay, we inserted this dog spike to behold the better gauge. Okay, so let's come to the second one, that is the screw tag. So as the main disadvantage of dog spike is, it gets loosened during vibrations and impact loads. So to overcome that drawback, the next one is screw spikes. Okay, these screw spikes are tapered with V-threads. Okay, here we have thread arrangement so that it cannot get loosened during vibrations and impact loads. Okay, V-thread used to fasten rails with timber sleeper. This type of spike is also used for timber type of sleepers only. And the next one is, head is circular, also with square projection. Okay, the head is circular, but it also projects a square section. Okay, let's see a image. And it also has holding power double than that of dog spike. Why? Because here we are using threads. Okay, rather than impacting, we are doing some threads to hold the rails to the sleeper. So that's why its holding power is double than that of your dog spikes. Okay, and the last one is, these are very costly. Okay, we need to maintain those threads and we have to be a rounded head with the square projection. So that's why its cost is very high. See, this is a screw spike. See, these are the threads. It has a circular cross section with the square projection. See, this is the cross view. Okay, and these are better gauge maintenance, more difficult. Why? As we are inserting them through the sleeper, it may not be in a straight line. It may get divert from a straight line. So that's why it is very difficult to maintain the gauge using this screw spikes. And the next one is, driving operation is very similar to the dog spike. Whether we are generally, even though it has a threads, we generally use an impact loads to drive them into the timber sleepers. Okay, so these are the screw spikes. Okay, so let's see, this is the practical image. This is a rail, this is a timber sleeper. We are connecting the flange of the rail with this timber sleeper using this screw spikes. Okay, see here, you can also see here. Okay, This is the practical image. These two are the screw spikes. Coming to the next one, round spikes. These are also similar, but the head either cylindrical or hemispherical. The shape is not circular. And these are mainly used to fix chains of the bull-headed rails to the wooden sleepers. Here we are not directly connecting the flange of the rail to the sleepers. Here we are using the chains to connect rails to the sleepers. So why we are using these rounded spikes? To hold the chains with the sleepers. Okay, there is no connection for the rails. Rails are jointed with the chains. Chains are jointed with the sleepers. Okay, here we are using to connect chains of bull-headed rails. Chains are mainly used in the case of bull-headed rails or double-headed rails only. Okay, for flat-footed rails, we don't use any chains. So these are used for fixing chains of bull-headed or double-headed rails to the wooden sleepers. Okay, the third type of spikes are also used for wooden sleepers only, and these are generally limited use only. Okay, so coming to the next one, fourth one, elastic spike. So this is the only spike that going to use for other than timber sleepers. The previous three type of spikes are used only for timber sleepers, whereas this elastic spikes can also be used for steel sleepers or for concrete sleepers also. Okay, coming to the next one, this is also overcoming the problem of dog spike heads. What is this? Dog spikes cannot absorb the impact and vibrations. So instead of it, they are getting loosened. But here in case of elastic spikes, here the head absorbs the wave motion. Wave motion means vibrations. Okay, vibrations of rail without getting it loose. Okay, this is overcoming the drawback of dog spike. So what is the drawback? Those are getting loosened during vibrations and impacts. But here the head of the elastic spike absorbing the wave motion. Wave motion means vibrations and impacts, and not to getting loosened. Okay. And next one is, they provide better grip and result in reduction of wear and tear of the rail. If there is a strong grip between the rail and sleeper, there is no wear and tear. Okay, if they are getting loosened, there is a possibility of mechanical wear and tear between rails and sleepers. Okay. The next one is, these are commonly used in British Railways. This is in our previous days, but nowadays these are mainly used in Indian Railways also. See, these are the only type of spikes that we are using in present days. Okay, wherever you see, you find this type of spikes only. We cannot see those screw spikes or dog spikes or rounded spikes. Okay, so this is a rail. The flange of the rail is connected to the sleeper. This is a bearing plate. Okay, the flange of the rail is connected to the sleeper and bearing plate using this elastic spikes. Okay, the red one is a elastic spikes. There is also another shape. See, that is known as pandrel clip. Pandrel clip or elastic spikes, both are similar. This is the shape, another shape. Okay, these are available in two shapes. The first shape is this one, and the second one is like a pandrel. That's why it is known as pandrel clip. Okay, these two are the shapes available for elastic spikes. Okay, so let's come to the next topic. Chains. Okay, what are the types of spikes we completed? Dog spikes, screw spikes, rounded spikes and elastic spikes. Okay, dog spikes are very cheap and easily available, but their main drawback is they are getting loosened during impact and vibrations. Okay, the next one is screw spikes. They are having some screw type structure that are better for holding the rails to the sleepers. Okay, and the third one is round spikes. They are not used to connect the rails to the sleepers. Instead, they are used to connect chains of a bull-headed rails. See, here we are discussing about the chains. Okay, they are used to connect the chains to the sleepers. Okay, and the last one is elastic spikes. Frequently, we see only these elastic spikes only. Okay, they provide a better grip to hold the rails to the sleepers. There is two shapes are available. The first one is rounded shape and the second one is pandrel shape. That's why it is known as pandrel clip. Okay, so the next one is chains. These are the excess fastenings. These are the excess fastenings that are used to connect bull-headed or double-headed rails to the sleepers. If we are having a flat-footed rails, there is no need of chains. Okay, so let's see first what is a chain. See, this is a bull-headed rails having a larger head and smaller foot. Okay, we cannot directly connect them to the slippers. So what we are doing, this is a chair arrangement. See, this is a chair. The chairs are holding the bull headed rails. Here we use the bolts to fix chairs to the slippers. Okay, here we use this round spikes. Okay, see another image. See, this is a practical image of a chair. In the center we provide these rails, whether round head, whether bull headed rails or double headed rails, and here we have some holes to fix the chairs to the slippers. Okay, it is very difficult to connect bull headed rails to the slippers. That's why externally we are adding these chairs. Okay, so let's see point by point. These are mainly used for, as we discussed, for double headed rails for or bull headed rails. What is double headed rail? Double headed rail means the head and the foot both are of same dimensions. Okay, they are invented in an idea that if the head of the rail get eroded, then we just invert it. But what is we found? The bottom of the head is also seems to have indentations. So it is not in a smooth surface, which consumes so much of friction. Okay, so we need so much of fuel to run over a indented rail surface. So that's why this idea is flapped. Okay, flat double headed rails are outdated. To overcome it, we are using bull headed rails, reducing the foot of the rail and increasing the head of the rail, so that it provide better surface for the wheels. But these are also outdated. Why? For these two types of rails, we need access arrangements like chairs and keys. We need not only chairs, we also need keys. Okay, to connect rails to the sleepers. So in order to remove these chairs and keys, we are using these flat-footed rails. Okay. So why we are using chairs and keys also for double-headed, bull-headed rails? Chairs are used to support them in position. Okay. If you directly connect them to the sleepers, they may tilt or they may get loosened. So in order to prevent that loosening and tilting, we are using chairs to keep them in proper position. Okay. And the next one is, they are generally made up of cast iron. Okay, or maybe steel. And the next one is, chairs have been fixed to the sleepers using wooden spikes screws. Okay, or fan bolts or spikes. These three arrangements we can use to connect the chairs to the sleepers. In spikes, we use rounded spikes. Okay, rounded spikes are used to connect chairs of your bull headed rails to the sleepers. That we learn in rounded spikes. Okay. And the last one is, chairs consists of two jaws and a rail seat. See those two jaws. See, this is a one jaw. This is an another jaw. And the bottom one is a rail seat. Okay. Between these two jaws, we place the rails. Okay. And the rail seat is used to connect it to the sleepers. See, the center one is a key. That is our next topic. So in our next topic, we are going to learn about these keys. At present, we are discussing with this rail arrangement, chair arrangement. Okay. So these are the chairs used to keep the double headed or bull headed rails in position and also to connect them with the sleepers. Okay. These can be used for any type of sleepers or any type of sleepers. That is wooden sleep, for wooden sleepers we can use, for steel sleepers we can use, and mostly these are useful for concrete sleepers. Okay, so let's see the next one. See, this is the practical image. This is a rail. Okay, this is a chair arrangement. The chair is holding the rail in position with the help of keys. This is a key that we are observing here. This key is this one. Okay, so the chairs with the help of keys holding the double headed or bull headed rails in position, and also useful to fix it to the sleeper. See, these are the bolts. Okay, so this is a practical image. Coming to the next one, that is keys. Okay, keys we already seen. Keys are the arrangements to hold the bull headed rails or bull headed rails or double headed rails to the chairs with the help of keys. They are generally wedge shaped wooden or metal pieces. Okay, the wooden, they keep the rails in proper position. Even though we use the chairs, the bull headed or double headed rails may get tilted, okay, inside the two jaws. So in order to get tightened, what we are using, these keys. Okay, only with the help of chairs we cannot hold them in proper position. We also require these keys also. And the second one is, keys may be of wooden or metal and may be either straight or tapered. Okay, here we are not using this straight one, this is a tapered key, right? Instead of this, we can also use straight keys also. Okay. Yeah, wooden keys are very cheap. But what is the problem with the wooden keys? They may get attacked by the white ants. So that's the disadvantage. So that's why we do not use this wooden keys. And the second one is steel keys. But its initial cost is very high. Here I am stressing initial cost. Why? There is no maintenance cost for the steel keys. Okay, so the initial cost only high for the steel keys, but if you use this wooden keys, you need to provide so much of money for the maintenance work. But whereas for steel keys, initial cost may be high, but the maintenance cost is very less. And the second one is, and the life, coming to the life, the life of a steel keys is about 10 times more than that of wooden keys. Okay, if wooden keys comes for 3 years, then we can use this steel keys for 30 years. That is the difference in lifespan. Okay, that's why in present days all the wooden keys are replaced with the steel keys. Okay, so coming to the next one, bearing plate. Why we are using these bearing plates? Bearing plates are mainly used in case of wooden sleepers only. Why? See, this is a wooden sleeper. Over the wooden sleeper, we are using flat footed rails. Okay, if they are flat footed rails of heavy weight, if they are carrying so much of traffic, heavy weights, then this rail, the foot of the rail may get punched through the wooden sleepers. So in order to prevent the punching of a rail into the sleeper, what we are using here, we are using a bearing plate to distribute the load over a larger area. Okay, see that one. These are generally rectangular plates made up of mild steel or cast iron, that is the material. And the second one is, these are used below only flat footed rails. Okay, we are not using them for bull headed rails or double headed rails to distribute the load over a large area or timber sleeper. If the sleeper is not made up of timber, if it is a steel sleeper or concrete sleeper, there is no need of using this bearing plates. Okay, if the loads are very, very high, then we can use. There is no restriction to use only for the timber sleepers. They are generally used for timber sleepers only. Okay, if you require, we can also use it for steel and concrete or area of timber sleeper. Here we are specifically representing that they are used for flat footed rails and timber sleepers only. Okay, the next one is, generally they are of two types. The first one is flat bearing plates. Second one is canted. Canted means with some slope. Okay, the inner, the one edge may be thick and the other edge may be thin. One is thin and the other one is thick. So this type of bearing plate is known as canted bearing plates. So why we use this canted bearing plates? To provide a tilting of rail. Or if you do not provide the edging of sleepers, then we use this bearing plates to tilt the rails to a slope of 120. Okay, coming to the next one. So this is a bearing plate. See, these two are holes. There are two arrangements. For the bearing plates, we use generally elastic spikes. Okay, and these are used to, these are the holes for the bolts to connect to sleepers. Okay, this one is to connect the flat footed rails to the bearing plate using a elastic spikes. And these two holes are to connect the bearing plate to the sleepers. Okay, so let's see, this is a practical image. See, this is an elastic spike. The rails are connected to the bearing plate using elastic spikes. And here we see two more holes. These are the, what are the type of screws that we are using here? Circular with square projection. So those are screw spikes. Okay. So screw spikes are used to connect bearing plate to the sleepers. Here we are using two type of screws. Elastic spikes to connect the rails to the bearing plate. Screw spikes to connect bearing plate to the sleepers. Okay, see, these are the spikes used to connect bearing plate to the sleepers, and this is a rail. Okay, so this is what is a bearing plate. Next one, as we already discussed, flat bearing plates. Two types of bearing plates are there. The first one is flat bearing plates. They are used at locations where rails are laid flat. This is a very rare type of bearing plate that we use, because we cannot use locations where the rails are laid flat. The rails are never be flat. They must be tilted to inwards at a slope of 1:20. Okay. So in these cases, we use the flat bearing plates, but those are very rare cases. Also, they are used in turnouts, tracks and points and crossings. Okay, if you need to move track from one track to another track, there the load may be very high due to the impacts. So in such cases, we use this flat bearing plates. And the second one is canted bearing plates. So why we are using? They are used to maintain the inward tilt of 1:20, right? We must provide the tilting of rails and coning of wheels. So why we need to provide those and all? We already completed in coning of wheels topic. Okay. So canted bearing plates are used on tops, soft timber sleepers, beneath outside rail. Okay. For example, in a curve, this is a curve. This one, the inner one is known as inner rail, and the outer one is known as outer rail. So these are used at the places of outer rail only. So see, and a soft timber sleeper beneath outside rails on curves, okay, where rails are laid at an inward tilt of 1:20. These are generally used where we do not provide a edging of sleepers. If you provide the edging of sleepers, then we can use flat footed rails instead of canted bearing plates. But if you do not provide any edging of sleepers, in such cases we use this canted bearing plates to provide a inward tilt of 1:20. Okay. So coming to the next one, advantages. So what are the various advantages and disadvantages of this bearing plates? Coming to the advantages, as the name it indicates, it is a bearing plate, so it has to distribute the load over a larger area. Okay, distribute the load to sleepers over a large area, and also prevent sinking of rails. So here we are calling it as punching of rails. Okay, prevent the sinking of rail in soft wooden sleepers. And the second one is, they also prevent the destruction of sleepers due to rubbing action. If you do not provide any bearing plates, we kept the rail straightly and a sleeper. So while the train moving, there is a chances of rubbing action. So due to this rubbing action, the sleeper may get destroyed. So to prevent the destruction of sleepers, we use this bearing plates. And the next one is, they are useful to better maintenance of gauge. Okay. And the last one is, they are helping in firm and perfect holding of spikes to sleepers. If you do not provide these bearing plates, we just insert the spikes into the sleepers, okay, which is not maybe perfectly firm in position. But if you use these bearing plates, we kept the spikes through those bearing plate holes, which provides firm and perfect holding of spikes to the sleepers, which prevents shifting of rails. Okay, if the spikes get loosened, then the gauge may disturb. The rails move away from its position. Okay. So coming to the disadvantages, plates rattle when they loose. That is the first disadvantage. And the second one is, for example, any one hole of a spike is failed and a new hole is to be made. Okay, one spike is failed, we need to make another hole and insert another spike. So in such cases, all spikes in the bearing plate to be pulled out. Okay, we strongly fix the spikes. If one fail, we need to pull back all the spikes, which may loosen the spikes. Okay. And the last one is, the bearing plates admit moisture. The bearing plates are made up of steel, so obviously they absorb the moisture and get corroded. Okay, this is the another disadvantage of bearing plates. So let's summarize today's class. So the first topic that we learned today is spikes. Okay, spikes are nothing but nails with head. Okay, nails with flat head. Spikes, there are four types of spikes available. The first one is dog spikes, and the second one is screw spikes, and the third one is elastic spikes, and the fourth one is round spikes. These are the four types of spikes available. And the second topic is chairs. These are mainly used for bull-headed rails and flat foot bull-headed rails and double-headed rails only. And the third one is keys. And the fourth one is bearing plate. Bearing plate, it may be a flat or canted. Two types of bearing plates are available, flat and canted. So this is one four topics that we learn in today's class. Okay, in the next class we are going to learn about blacks and creep of rails. Thank you.